Hey everybody, I'm Laura, and today we're going to talk about the mindset of being a follower. How many of you have heard this? Just follow, or it's always the leader's fault. That kind of stuff drove me crazy when I was a student. If it's always the leader's fault, then why aren't I up there teaching right now? If it's so easy to follow, why isn't every follow exactly the same amount of good? It made no sense. Also, what about this one? Don't anticipate. Okay, all right, I know I shouldn't anticipate, but what should I be doing? I want to be able to proactively focus on something. The goal of a follow and the goal of a leader from a technical standpoint are fundamentally two different things. We're both dancers, we're both listening to the music, we're both expressing ourselves, but our goals of how to do that on a technical level are very different. Now, of course, reality is more complicated than that, but on a very simple level, leads invent the moves. They've come up with a great sequence, they have a great series of ideas of what to do, and follows do not care about that. Moves aren't our domain. If we really want a tuck turn to happen, who knows if a tuck turn will happen? If we learn a really fancy move in class, who knows if we'll ever see that move again? So that is not our thing to care about. Now this is difficult because a lot of the times in class, what is the teacher teaching you? A move. Therefore, how do you know if you did it right? You do the move. So even in class, our mindset has to be totally different than that of a leader. Because of all this emphasis on the move, it's really tempting to try to just guess. I get it. It's hard. To be a follow, in my opinion, is to be a magician. You have to do super intricate, complicated things in the midst of not knowing what it is. And then retrospectively, you look behind you and you're like, oh my gosh, that was 18 turns of redirecting a kickball chain. My gosh. It's amazing what follows do. So if we don't care about the move, then what do we care about? Well, as a super oversimplification, we care about ourselves. That's what we have control over. We have control over our rhythm, our shape and our symmetry, our momentum, and our sense of dancing. So whenever I'm social dancing, or whenever I'm doing a competition, or whenever I'm doing choreography, or whenever I'm in class, those are the main things that I'm trying to think about. With the exception of solo jazz, let's not overthink it. For rhythm, you want to step right on the beat and hold yourself to a really high standard. Keep in mind, you had to be really good to play in the rhythm section of the Count Basie band. Hold yourself to that standard. If your rhythm were amplified, would you enjoy that sound? Would you dance to it? Would Frankie Manning dance to it? So you want to think, triple step, 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 kick step, hold. Are you on your left foot or are you on your right foot? Even if my leader is off beat, I'm going to do my best to hold that rhythm down unless he's really holding me in closed position. You don't wear jeans at a wedding, see if you can meet in the middle. But as soon as I get freedom, I'm going to express my timeliness in that rhythm. And hopefully that will bring my leader onto a better beat. After all, we're partners. For my shape and my symmetry, that's one of the main ways the leader is able to communicate with me. I want to see if I can keep my body in between my arms. I want to make sure I don't let my arm go out, but I always sort of keep a connection between my body and my hand. If my hand points in a direction, generally speaking, I want my body and my feet to point in that same direction. Obviously, there's going to be some flexibility in endpoints, but I want to see if I can be as aware of what my hand is feeling and translating that into my body as I possibly can. And I'm going to try to separate my awareness from my expectation of what I think I know the move is. It's really tempting to get just the beginning of the move and then being like, ah, I know what this is. It's a swing out. Boom. Nailed it. High five. Shh. Lindy hop. Resist. Resist. I'm gonna try to remember that every lead I dance with is different, and every song I dance to might give me something slightly different, even though that leader might be trying to lead me into that same rock step, or that same tuck turn, or that same swing out. Be aware of the gradient between point A and point B. Lindy hop is a journey, man. Speaking of journey, my momentum. I wanna go without speeding up or slowing down. I want to go as slowly as my leader will allow me to go instead of jumping to where I think my leader is asking me to go to. And that applies to both linear motion and rotational motion. Something that helps me think about this is if I were on roller skates or if I were in a river and the current is washing past me. It's not that I'm out of control. It's not that I'm falling. I'm holding myself, but I'm feeling this constant pull of momentum to a very specific point in space behind me. I try to think about my direction, not as that way, but as towards Rachel Alma's Vegan Eats. I'm going exactly there. Now, we've talked about all this technique, but we still have to come back to our dancing. That is one of the things that's kind of in peril if you think about this technique. It's really common that followers think of themselves as being refrigerators on wheels or being asteroids in space. And we try to dance with our eyes closed so we can really feel what the leader is asking us. And I understand that that might get you to a particular mental space, but I think it gets you away from dancing. While you're following, you have to dance at the same time, which involves looking at your leader, because sometimes you're getting really good information from your eyes. Some of it's a red herring, but some of it is the vibe of the move, a preparation for what is about to come for the next few milliseconds of your life. While you're dancing, you want to be able to move your head around and be aware of your surroundings. While you're dancing, you want to be able to throw your hands up in the air. You want to be able to have access to your knowledge of the song you're dancing to, where the phrase is, where the chorus is, where that particular beat in the trumpet section is that you love so much. You don't want to get rid of that just because you're trying to be technically good. I know that can be a really difficult balancing act. I definitely struggle with being calm and being technical in the midst of feeling so much energy and joy from listening to a crazy jazz song that I am in love with. So if that's a struggle for you, do not worry. I totally get you. Allow yourself to be pulled from one side to the other. While you're out on the dance floor having the best time of your life, see if a little part of you can notice your momentum and your shape and the quality of your rhythm. And if you lose it for a second, don't worry about it. You can bring yourself back. Just make sure you don't lose it so much that Lindy Hop is no longer fun for two, but just for you. Now, I find this really empowering because that means I can do my job. I can focus on my rhythm, my shape, my momentum, my dancing, regardless of how experienced my lead is. And the conviction that I have with my rhythm and my dancing can help bring my leader into a better space to dance with me. Partnership. Now, it needs to be said, all this technique is stuff that I find works for me and helps further my values in the dance. But we're not all the same. Our bodies aren't the same, and what we want out of dancing isn't necessarily the same. What I'm trying to do is trying to find a good balance between being able to express myself and being able to accurately hear and react to what the lead is asking me to do. But as we discussed earlier, that line can be a difficult balancing act, and how far you want to push the line one way or the other might be different. And your leader might also have different preferences. This is part of the important work that you have to do as a student. You have to decide where you want that line to be, and you have to decide what techniques help you achieve that balance. And where that line is might change over the course of your dancing, and that's totally fine. Lindy Hop is a dance about individuality and expression, so you want to decide where you are as an individual. Hopefully this was helpful for you. If you have any questions, leave a comment. If you want to support my channel, click subscribe and then head on over to my Patreon, where people like you can keep videos like this free for everyone in the world. Thank you very much. And of course, the best way to learn how to dance is to dance and 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 to dance.